Everybody, it's Evicta, and I wanted to do something a little bit different today since we're going into a brand new work week here, the Binding of Isaac Evicta Repentance series. First off, yesterday's video almost is at 5,000 likes. We're still a couple hundred off, so make sure you go check that one out. You definitely missed an explosive end to the Tainted Eden week, which was a lot of fun, of course. And again, thank you all very much for making the previous like goal happen. Also, today we're going to be doing just a classic Isaac run because I want to see exactly how powerful can you get with just go in the standard regular route. We're going to go back to Devil Deal meta. Let's just see if we can make it happen. Is it still possible to be balling out of control in Repentance? We're going to find that out today. Of course, it's only going to be a sample size of one pool, but maybe we'll do a whole week of classic Isaac runs. I don't know. Let me know in the comments down below what you all want to see. Here's your meme of the day. This is brought to you by DDub0823. Title of the thread was, "How does he do it?" Evicta finding secret rooms like a scientist. Evicta finding the boss room. Yes. One of these is a lot harder to find than the other. I'll let you figure that one out. Hop on in. Let's just do a freaking classic Isaac run. This is going to be Romeo, Mike 6 Zulu, 2 Bravo, Golf, Papa. So we're playing as base Isaac. How long has it been since we played as base Isaac? I don't even know. And for those of you wondering if the cough was gone, no, it's not. Yes, the cough directly caused me to run into the fire. It wasn't my fault. It was the cough's. Let's start off with Dirty Mind here. Dirty Mind is going to give us an army of poops. Well, technically an army of dips whenever we end up destroying a poop pile, which we will most likely see probably in this level. But yeah, base Isaac is base Isaac. You see the starting stats here. This is exactly what you get. This is what every single run that you've ever seen on the channel. This is what every single run gets weighed against is the base stats of regular Isaac. So 1.0 movement speed, 3.50 damage, 2.73 tiers. And it starts off with the D6, which is going to give us an item pedestal reroll. Also starts off with, I believe, one bomb. You see our army of dips here. I am going to use one bomb just to get one key. And the secret room should be to the left of here. Let me go double check on that. I believe it's here. Yes, you can destroy you can destroy your own dips, excuse me. I tried some new, not really new, but I mean it's new to me. I tried some ginger and lemon tea, which I was not a massive fan of. I don't like ginger. Even my dad, like, when he uses ginger in like cooking and stuff, because my dad cooks a lot of Chinese food at home. I don't like it. It's too much of it's an offensive smell to me. Mixing with lemon, the lemon definitely seemed to help out, but it didn't stop the cough. Small rock here. I'm not going to reroll that. We are going to have a reroll for our item pedestal in the boss room. But yeah, you know, I want to see what happens if you just go for classic Isaac run. Is it still possible to get out of control in Repentance? Despite the nerfs, despite all the item changes, all the new items, can we actually do it? Going back to the classic Devil Deal meta. Excuse me. Also, I don't know how that dip ended up yeeting the mini Gemini that far, but Isaac physics be Isaac physics. We are going to get tears up. I'm not going to reroll that. There's no soul heart that we can see. I think the super secret room's got to be here. The only place it can be. And yeah, just going to head on down. Great start though, small rock. All right, let's see if we get some help out. We did not get any HP on that last floor, of course. But again, I'm happy that we got some damage in the form of small rock. And Dirty Mind is going to help us out a little bit with crowd control. But as you just saw against Mini Gemini, they can send things just kind of hurtling through the stratosphere if you're not careful. Generally speaking, I try not to destroy the poop piles until after I'm done clearing a room, unless if it's a boss room, of course. Because you want to save those dips, kind of treat them like flies. They act as a good meat shield, and they do deal some damage. They don't deal damage like a fly would, but you know what I mean? Oh yeah, 8-inch nails, absolutely. Big damage up now, 7.00 damage. It's fantastic. Might even be able to get boss rush out of here. Let's see. My army of dips, we're looking pretty good. I think that could be fun. We go from Tainted Eden to just regular Isaac. Be like an Isaac only week. Some people may say that's too easy. Well, I say, well, you know what? Let's find out if that's too easy or not. Base Isaac is still very good, and what makes him good is just the D6. Being able to give yourself options and reroll reroll item pedestals is super good. You have an Eternal Heart here, so the Duke of Flies shouldn't really be too much of an issue here. Absolutely smoking Duke. And he goes. Take the HP upgrade. Aggie's Faith as well. Not the double deal, Isaac. Rotten Baby, with this damage, I think it's definitely worth it. So I am going to take up Rotten Baby. We're not going to reroll anything, and I think we just head on down. There you go. So Maggie's Faith is going to give us another Eternal Heart at the start of every single floor. It was instrumental in helping us with Lazarus. And Lazarus, to be precise. And Jacob and Hee-Haw as well. It might be here, but I'd be surprised. Let's see. It still could be there, but again, I'd be surprised. No, oh, poops. Okay, they're okay. They're okay. They lived. And I still don't know if it's there or not. I'm just going to drop a bomb. Not there. It was a long shot, but like there were so many non-conclusive conclusions there. Whether or not I could confirm nor deny if that secret room was there. I mean, it was still possible, given all the tiles that were around it, but it was unlikely. Go right straight to the boss here, and I'm fine with that as well. Wow. Well then, in true life does not imitate art, I have not been able to find a single secret room where I thought it was. I would have bet money on that one. Wish I had taken that bet. Actually don't, because I have to pay for new tires in my car. Ew, by the time this goes live, I think I would have already paid for them, maybe? Maybe? There we go. We do not get Devil Deal. We get another Tears Up, though. We're going to go back and check out our item room. Okay, we get to use our first reroll in two floors here. Yeah, buddy. Mysterious Liquid. Going to be huge here with this damage and... On top of that, our tears rate is going to be able to apply that effect even faster just because we're going to get more shots off per second. And that's a ton of extra damage. I'm telling you, we're looking real good. Got ourselves a library here. Needles are not going to go anywhere in this build, that's for sure. We got him nailed down. You need to be careful of our HP, though. Well, at least of our soul hearts. We don't want to... Okay, never mind. We can now go into the curse room. Pretty much guilt-free. That's the soul of Lazarus. Volcane. I think it just spawns a bunch of money, doesn't it? No, it acts as a dad's key, that's right. I'm not going to go in the cursed red rooms. I don't care that much about it. Get High Priestess card, which we are going to use against the boss. little bit unfortunate though that I didn't. I should have looked up what the Soul Cane did, because could have gotten into the library and we wouldn't be wasting our rerolls, potentially anyway. Got ourselves another bomb here. Yeah, I think the first key should be used to get into the library. We can determine whether or not we want to reroll in there or wait. Should probably save our rerolls for the devil deal. We could get guaranteed bookworm here. Yeah, I think we're only going to have one reroll on this floor because we've already cleared most of it. We arrived here with basically no rerolls. Of course, now the level's starting to open up here, so maybe. Let's give it one more room. Okay. All right. Like, well, we don't want to go back yet, but okay. All right, got ourselves the Ave. It's gonna be Rag Mega. Like Rag Dead. You know what? I'm not gonna take perfection. I mean, I'm gonna take safety pin, however. And this is I believe this is Pogatory or Purgatory. Roll that, get the pack. That's what we're talking about. Damage, finally. Maxed out tiers. Still have not found the item room yet. And this just, again, this feels like a good old classic run. So far, anyway. Yeah. Take rubber cement all day, every day. Man, we are in hard mode, right? What's going on with this repentance here? I'm starting to question things. 3 cents for a bomb is not really worth it. I'm gonna grab this half soul heart here. Greed fight? Oh no, greed fight. Wow. Okay, so I think what we do is we take some money out. We're going to buy the 9-volt. We're going to go all the way down to the library. Oh, by the way, when I talked about the Charge Penny achievement yesterday, I stupidly forgot to mention that I didn't get Dead God yet. And that is because I think the only other achievement that I'm missing now, and I totally forgot about this achievement, is I have to touch every item. Now, what items I haven't touched yet, I can just look up in the bestiary and in the item list. But I'm trying to suss it out myself. I don't want to like potentially spoil anything by looking through it. But I think I need death certificate. And one other item, maybe. I don't remember. At this point, I don't remember everything that I've unlocked. But if it comes to it, I will look at the list. I'm just, you know, I want it to be kind of like, oh, when it pops up, you know what I mean? You might be asking yourself, what is the point of rerolling the library if we're not going to take anything? Well, we're trying to exhaust the library item pool. That way, if we do spawn another one, which is unlikely but possible, if we do spawn another library that has item pedestals in it, it will no longer contain any of the book items. It will simply just have regular items, and that's pretty good. Yeah, why not? Rubber cement's going to give us a nice extra application of mysterious liquid. Oh, you're still alive. For some reason, the dips made it look like it wasn't alive. Back to $0.07. It was a little bit of a gamble there using our only key. I don't know what's going on with Lush. She's just bouncing all over the place. The 8-inch nails, they do have a kick to them. Didn't know it was that much, though. There's another one of you, huh? Okay, let's stop getting hit by these regular old leapers. Okay. We'll go in the curse room since we do have a full charge, and it was a complete waste of time. Oh no, we got two pennies, you know, maybe not a huge waste of time, big waste of health though. Go ahead and get our dip army going. For that item room here. But you know, this is going pretty well. We will actually, this is no doubt about it, unless something catastrophic happens. We will make boss rush. And with this tears rate and damage, we may be able to actually just do it unless we teleport out, which I can because I can go find the fool card. Not on this floor, of course, but next floor. Definitely let me know if you like the idea of just doing like a classic Isaac run, maybe even a classic Isaac week, that we go back and explore all that Repentance has to offer. You know, we do an alt path run, we do a dogma run, all that kind of good stuff. it just feels right, you know. It just feels good to be playing Isaac again with the D sizzle, you know, old school vibes. I can use our only key for that, as I think that'd be a very big waste of resources, limited resources. Hey, there's a charge key. I'm gonna leave that there for a second. Hopefully we get a devil deal here. All right, Dips. Warm him. Warm him. Go. Did not get deal with the devil. Latch key. I think we do better. No. We're already capped on tiers. Although I think blue cap does break the tiers cap. What am I doing? I need to get the. I was about to walk all the way to the item room and then forget the charge key. This is wasting a lot of time, though. A lot of time. I don't want to skip our item room. I have not... Charged Penny is the other one. I have not picked up Death Certificate or Death's Certificate, something like that. And then Charged Penny, because I just unlocked that. So those are the two confirmed items I have not seen quite yet. Tech one is pretty darn awesome, especially with rubber cement and mysterious liquid. I don't think there's any way we pass that up. Thumb's purse, then we will take blue cap just to have it. And really we could go play the demon judgment. Just because we're going to get our HP back anyway that we're going to lose with this Eternal Heart. That sounds like a pretty pog to play here. Unless he pays out beforehand. Yeah. Yeah, so we didn't lose the Eternal Heart. I'll take blue cap. We'll head on down. Does not break the tears cap. Okay. We only have 2 minutes, less than 2 minutes, to find the full card so we can go steal an item from Boss Rush. Ideally, while we also have a full charge on the tier on the D6. You see here the multiplicative properties of rubber cement really showing in the spotlight here with us having tech one. I mean, it's able to hit the same target twice or more. And then, of course, we're proccing Mysterious Liquid all over the place. That's right. I said it. Leave behind those little creep trails that deal a good amount of damage to anything that touches it. And unless there's flying, unless the enemies are flying, there's a whole lot of Mysterious Liquid. Absolutely doing tons of damage here. I don't know if Science Infection works with Tech 1. I don't think it does, but... Oh, apparently it does. Take that back. As you saw right there, the problem with Mysterious Liquid is that you also don't know... It will override the creep on the ground already. Hey, we're back over 300. That's what I like to see. I bombs, still don't know where our tinted skull is. Well, science infection there, proc, and then move towards other enemies. Like a, it's got like kind of like a homing on it. Oh, I did. Okay. All right. Let's not do that again. We only have nine. Well, we basically have a minute. We're at 19 minutes on the dot almost going into here. I remember what Empress does. Oh, it gives us the Sun card. Our tears rate is out of control. I should say that for Boss Rush, if we are going to do Boss Rush. If we do Boss Rush, we would have to, like, actually do it. Destroyed our movement speed, however. 73%, lol, 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 lol. I will take Mycosis. The only reason why I'm doing this boss rush here is just because of our tears rate. I remember the Empress card, the inverted Empress card lasts for the entire floor if it's just like for 60 seconds. Stone cold. Right in the face of Stain. Didn't even flinch. Yeah, we can't stand in front of him. Chub over there or someone. Oh no, Dark One. And, you know, given our damage, our damage is good. 7.51 is good, but it's not like overwhelmingly good. What's making this happen is our tears rate in Tech One, really. My God. No, it's not my God. Definitely need some movement speed here. Definitely feels good just to be doing a straight up boss rush here as regular Isaac. Who would have thought? One extreme to the other. Well, maybe not extreme, but there's like newness to classicness. I was trying to play chicken with Death's Horse. Turns out, don't do that. Prefer not to lose this Eternal Heart if we can help it. Hey, everybody. Oh, it didn't show. All right, so there's Boss Rush, and we'll head on down. 73%, lol. Classic. All right, we have one Soul Heart that can protect us, and our Devil Deal here is the last guaranteed Devil Deal that we'll get on this run. And I don't know if the Devil Deals have really made all that much of an impact as they traditionally have on this run so far. That's not being rhetorical either. It's just that, you know, the pact, yes, the pact was a huge help to us. But is it really carrying us more than Tech 1 is? I wouldn't say so. I'd even say that Eight Inch Nails was carrying us harder than the pact has so far. Three Rotten Hearts, pretty darn good. Nearly find our boss, it's gonna be Mama Gertie. Hello, Mama. There goes Mama Gertie, we get another HP upgrade, which I'm gonna leave right there. Get the twins, Jello, multi-dimensional baby. Honestly, I'm just gonna send it. I know the twins are good, but... oh, okay, well, I mean, you know. You gotta have Brimstone. I mean, you gotta have Brimstone. Movement speed still is suffering a bit. Okay. Brimstone, Rubber Cement is just so good. And then you combine that with Tech 1. And you just got a cool looking shot here. It would be cool if it was red instead of like Christmas green, but... No, we're getting the spirit things. I mean, Christmas is only, what, like 6 months away? No big deal, right? Aggie's Faith doing a great job at keeping us afloat here. My God. Oh my gosh. Did you see the split shot? What on earth is doing that over there? Oh, because it's bouncing back and forth and back and forth again. Okay. The range on the rubber cement bounce is a lot more generous than I remember it being. I mean, Brimstone gives us unlimited range, but that's not what I mean. You know what I mean? I don't know what I mean. But I will be doing a YouTube stream sometime this week. I don't know. I don't have a day for you. But it will be soon-ish. Probably like, I don't know, Wednesday. No, not Wednesday. Maybe Tuesday. Maybe today. I don't know. Probably not today. I will be doing a YouTube stream sometime this week. Look forward to that. I always do. It was great seeing the mosh pit. We'll take consolation prize. Give us a little bit of an extra tears up. I'm surprised it didn't go to our movement speed, to be honest. He's done it. If you time it just right, you can walk across without stopping. You won't get hit. It's a very tough timing to get, though. 33.8%. Just don't get hit, forehead. We will head on up. Where Brimstone really comes in clutch. We can take out the Deacons. Although we still somehow got hit. I guess we got hit by Crack the Sky. I swore that I was already dead. Go for a soul heart here. Not gonna happen. Ooh. Knockout punch. Knockout drops. I don't know how it works with Brimstone. It'd be cool if Brimstone procced him. Like, instead of a blood beam, it was just a stream of like fists. The old Team Tech Stone here. Showing me how it's done. Taking it back to old school classic. Wow, okay. The Dips just swarmed war, just said, nope, we're not having any of that. I'll try not to take any half red hearts because we obviously care about polar invincibility in case we need it. And there's the southwest part of this map. Those of you playing along at home, how does he do it? Oh, I did hear the psh. I done heard it. This card's gonna help out our damage against Blue Baby or Isaac. Either one. Man, this movement speed. All right, my boy. Going up against Tech Stone. Good luck, Isaac. Mysterious Liquid and Mercosiosis, whatever it is, mushroom one. Absolutely crushing Isaac. We're going to coast in here, so. Not a fan of any of those, to be honest. I was thinking, I was like, do we want Ice Cube Baby? But nah, I don't think we need him. And look at the knockback there from the tears, from knockout punch. I'm gonna kill Blue Famine second here because you want to get the soul heart if you can. Yep. Thank you. We're just cruising to the finish line here. Now, if we end up fighting Delirium, we do have, we do have Polar Invincibility, but, like, I don't trust our movement speed, man. I really don't. What? Okay, apparently, knockback means pull them to you. Sure, Isaac, sure. Oh, okay, we're just gonna keep on doing this, huh? Before you say, oh, he was bouncing off the wall. Timmy, were you watching the screen? He's nowhere near the wall. After the first time. Okay. Go back and re-roll the chest. Totally forgot about it. Tech 2. Tech 2, Shield of Tears. I just want a little bit of movement speed. Here's what I'll go up here just to get some full charges. Some pretty softball rooms outside of the adversary rooms that I'm fine with. More, we can re-roll. All right, show us the money. I would fight Megastan if we end up getting the key, Dad's key. Just don't. I don't think they're good. Dunce cap, yeah, we would have two brimstones, but not straight ahead. No, dunce cap causes more problems than it solves. Armor boy we will take. This is dead end anyway, so there you go. All right. Yeah, today is going to be a very long day, and I appreciate everyone sharing the kind words. People apparently have had similar instances in their cars and stuff, which like I said yesterday, it's not worth getting mad over, really. There's bigger stuff to get mad at. Even then, like, I don't really get mad. Like to be 100% completely honest, what is this? Thick-blooded. The only thing that makes me mad these days is when Isaac, like, gives me bad stats and bad tiers to start with, which is usually bad stats. That's like the only times I get like legit mad. You can't be mad at this run, that's for sure. But thank you for watching, everyone. Again, let me know what you think about the idea of doing like an all classic Isaac week. Just kind of mix up the just mix it up every now and then. Eden Week was a lot of fun, and I think that just regular Isaac Week would also be a ton of fun as well. Thank you, everybody, for liking, commenting, and subscribing. I hope you have a fantastic start to the brand new week here in the Mosh Pit. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Harry Moyd, Misty Front, Jack, Reuven, Kajubi, Dalin, G. Ben Gaijin, and Matt Long. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.